Hello children, Sai Ram. Welcome back to online computer class. Today we are going to continue our previous chapter, that is chapter number 8, browsing internet. Okay children, before we start, just have an overlook of previous chapter. We learned what is internet, then uses of internet and basic requirement for internet. Okay, so let's start. Now children, today we are going to learn about internet terms, then searching on internet, and learn about email. Okay. Okay children, now let's start with internet terms. These terms are help us to know more about internet. These terms are website, web page, web browser, URL and www. Okay, let's get more information about this term one by one. Okay, okay children, our first term is website. The information that we can get from internet is in the form of website and web pages. As a book contain a number of pages, similarly a website is a collection of related web pages which are linked to one another. Understand? Okay, our next term is web page. Okay, web page is a part of website, like of a book. It is put on the internet in the form of digital pages. Okay, web page contain text, graphics, videos, audios and link to other pages of website, and it provides us an information in any of them form. Okay, this is called web page. Okay children, our next term is web browser. Children, if you want to access the internet, you must have a web browser. Okay, web browser is a software application or a program. Using web browser, we can open any website. For any website, for that we have to type URL of that website in the address bar of a web browser. Let's see with an example. See here the website of Cartoon Network channel is open. Okay, here this is the address bar of web browser. If you want to open an any website, then we must need URL of that website. Okay, so here cartoonnetwork.com is the URL of Cartoon Network channel website. If we type this URL in the address bar, then click on search button and it will open the website of Cartoon Network of a channel that becomes C on the screen. Okay children, some popular web browsers are Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox and Internet Explorer. These browsers are very popular. But nowadays, Google Chrome is the most popular web browser, which is developed by the Larry Page and Sergey Brin. This 2% features is also given in your textbook at the top of the side of the page number 59. You can see. Okay, so this is called web browser. Understand, children? Okay, children, our next term is URL. URL stand for Uniform Resource Locator. U for uniform, R for resource, and L for locator. To visit or open any website, you need to know its address. As we see earlier in the website of the Cartoon Network channel, we have to type URL means address of any website to open any website. Okay, children, if you want to go to your friend's home, you need to know his address, right? Similarly, each website is identified by its unique address, which is known as URL. Okay, the URL should be entered in the address bar of a web browser. For example, www.discoverychannel.com. Here, this is the home page of Google Chrome. Okay, and in this is a address bar. In address bar, we have to type URL, means address of website. Here, type is www.google.com, right? And we can see that the front page, means home page of Google page, is open. Understand, children? This is called URL. Okay, children, our next term is www. www stand for World Wide Web. First W for world, second W for wide, and third W for web. It is very easy to learn. Okay. It is a network of website on the internet, which contain information in the form of text, picture, animation, and videos that can be accessed by people all over the world. In easy language, we say that www is a collection of website of internet. Okay. The picture is given here of a person is Tim Berners-Lee, who developed the www, means we can say that the founder of www. He is the founder of World Wide Web. Understand? So, student, this is the different kinds of internet terms we learn here. Okay. Okay, children. Now our next topic is searching on internet. Okay. Now what is searching? Children, on the internet, searching is just trying to find the information you need. Means whatever information you want, you can search on the internet. Okay, there are certain websites on the internet that help us to search a website containing a particular information. This website are popularly known as search engine. Okay, children, to search any information on the net, you have to follow these steps. What is that steps? Step number one is connect to the internet, open browser software and open any search engine like says Google. Okay, then type a few keywords about the informations like says Cartoon Network and press the search button. Means whatever your topic is there now related to that particular, if you want to information about that topic, you have to write that topic name and paste the search button. Press the search button. Okay. After that, it will display a list of website which have the related the information. Here, it will show the different kinds of website of that topic. You can open and see the information. Then read the information provided and click on the link you consider the most appropriate. The website will open. Okay, so student, this is the steps to open any this is the step for you have to search any topic on the internet. So let's see practically how it works. Okay children, let's see practically how to open up any search engine. Okay children, for that connect to the internet. See here, this is a Wi-Fi connection. Okay, before we start internet, you have to connect the on the Wi-Fi. Okay, open browser software. Here I open Google Chrome and open any search engine, say Google. See, this is called Google search engine. Then type a few keywords about the information like Cartoon Network and press the search button. See here, Cartoon Network. Like this and search. It will display a list of website which have the related information. Okay, then click read the information provided and click on the link you consider the most appropriate. The website will open. Means here you can see the different kinds of links. See, I click one link, click on one link. See, the related page will be open. Understand children? Like that, like this, you have to search any information with the help of search engine. Okay, understand children? Children, our next topic is email. Email stand for electronic mail. Email is similar to a letter. It is sent via internet. Okay, there are many email service provider in the world like Gmail, Yahoo Mail, Rediff Mail and Outlook, etc. Okay, Gmail is by far the most popular services and used by more than billions of people around the world. Okay, Gmail is the more popular. Understand, children? Children, an email is more advantageous of other. Why? Because email is free and relatively very fast as compared to snail mail. Email reaches its destination within a fraction of second. An email can contain text, audio, video, etc. And it may be short enough to one word and long up to a book. And last one, it can be sent to many people at a time within a second. Understand? To send any email, you need an email program and the email ID of the receiver. Understand? This is called email. Children, email. We can use email for different kinds of things, like send and receive messages. Means we can send an email message to any person with an email address. The message arrive in the recipient's mail inbox within a second or a minutes irrespective of his location. We can also read and reply to those messages. Second is send and receive file. Children, in addition to the normal text-based email messages, we can send almost any types of files in an email messages, including documents, pictures, and music. A file sent in an email messages is called attachment, indicated with a pin symbol. You can see in your book. Okay. Then send messages to group of people, which means we can send messages in the form of groups. Like we can send email to many people at the same time. Okay. After that, forward messages. Children, forward messages means when you receive an email, you can forward it to other without retyping it. Like WhatsApp, we get any messages in the WhatsApp, we can read and we don't want to type anything and just forward it to many people. Like this we can do here also. Okay, then sending email enough email is free. Means unlike sending a regular letter, means no stamp or fees is required, no matter where the recipient lives. The only charges that you pay are for an internet connection. Means sending email is completely free. Means you don't want to need to go any post office. Then there is no need to stamp or fee is required. Means it is completely free. Only we required a internet connection. Okay. So children, this is called an email. I hope you understand. Okay. Children, here our chapter is over now. Okay. Whenever you get the notes now, please complete your notes. Okay. Thank you. And once again, Sai Ram.